Nearly 20 years after the first Crusader, the 99 gathered the Jerusalem and formed one of the most mysterious brotherhoods in history. Their arm was to ensure the safety of pilgrims going to Holy Land. They called themselves the Poor Fellow Soldiers in Christ. However, they soon became known as the Knights Templar as we know today. They were one of the most powerful military order history had ever seen. So much so that, after a while, they reached an incredible will to lend money to famous kings of Europe. In this video, we will witness how they get this power. We will follow in the footsteps of the Templars from Jerusalem to Europe and uncover the historical truth behind the rapid rise of the order. As a result of the First Crusader, which ended with capture of Jerusalem by Crusaders on July 15, 1099. Four different Crusader states emerged in the Middle East. These were the County of Edessa, the Principality of Antioch, the County of Tripoli, and the Kingdom of Jerusalem. However, this newly emerging political sanctuaries, the region was military was very fragile, and even years after the establishment of Latin kingdoms, internal security could not be fully ensured. After the capture of the city, some of the Muslims in their religion settled on the hills around Jerusalem and caves nearby. This situation started to pose of the big problem for the Kingdom of Jerusalem over time. The Jaffa, Jerusalem, and Jericho Jerusalem routes used by Christian pilgrims were frankly attacked by these Muslims. As a solution to this, several military orders were established in this period to protect the pilgrim and to meet their various needs. This included the Knights of Holy Sepulchre, who were soon disbanded and murdered in the dusty pages of history after its foundation, and the Knights Hospitaller, who welcomed pilgrims and looked after their health. However, these two orders were insufficient to ensure the safety of pilgrims, and by the year of 1920, the attacks of the Muslims on pilgrimage routes were on increase. It was precisely during this period that two knights named Hugh the Pious and Godfrey the Saint Omer. During the Council of Nablus, which took place in 1120, they appeared before King Baldwin II of Jerusalem and proposed the establishment of new order. The suggestion was also supported by Jerusalem Patriarch Warmund. This new order was officially established in 1120 with approval of King of Jerusalem. Their statute, which they called by the rule, included the following statements: the order will have 10 knights under the command of the order to take pilgrims to the Jordan River, supplies or charities to carry pilgrims. They called themselves Pauperas Communitas Christi, or Poor Soldiers of Christ, but this name was mostly limited to official documents and few historical records. King Baldwin give part of his residence, the Al-Aqsa Mosque, to the knights. Christians believed that Masjid Aqsa was built on the side of the old Temple of Solomon, and this is why the Poor Soldiers Christ began to be called Knights Templar after their first residence in Jerusalem shortly after establishment. The order was founded in three basic principles. These were the principles of bounty, chastity, and obedience. However, the most important among them was the principle of poverty, which also in mentioned the name of the order. The symbol you see is one of the early symbols of the Knights Templar, two knights riding on horse. This symbol symbolizes the poverty and the simple life of the members of the order. But were the Templars really poor? This is quite difficult to answer, because many things about the period when the order was founded are still mystery today. E.g., most sources mention 9 founding members but give us only 8 names. There are Hodge the Pains, Godfrey the Saint Omer, Paint the Montider, Akramir the Saint Amant, Andre the Mombard, Gifford Bison, Russell, and Gondomar. The past of many of them has been erased in dusty pages in history. In other words, it's not possible to predict whether they were poor in their pre-order life. Whatever, they adopted the principle after the establishment of the order. However, it does not seem logical that a few ordinary men would appear. before the king of Jerusalem and purposed to establish a new sect. Therefore, historians argue that the principle of bounty adopted by knights was actually brought to the fore in the order gained sympathy and support of poor Christians and laid the groundwork for donations to order the coming years. However, there are historians who claim that knights were truly commended by the principle of bounty in early years of the order's founding. Even if this claim were true, this deviation of Templars would not last long, because within a few years its establishment, the order would experience a tremendous rise that even its own members could not imagine, and this ascension would bring great wealth of the poor soldiers of Jesus. There were many factors that played a role in the rapid rise of the two Knights Templar. The intellectual background and the worldly mission of the order was developed by Bernard, the abbot of Carissa Abbey, one of the most famous clergy of the time. Thanks for his efforts, the Knights Templar soon became a well-known order throughout Europe. In the same period, the first Grand Master of organization, which the pagans had begun to climb the career ladder rapidly. He was an ambitious and intelligent man. He had dynamic character. He soon developed close relations with the King of Jerusalem and the Patriarchs. In 1127, he was sent to Europe on a diplomatic mission on behalf of King Baldwin. The mission changed the fate of Templars forever. During his stay in Europe, Hugh the Pagans had the opportunity to meet many nobles and numerous clergy, including kings. He made long journeys as far as Britain and collected enormous donations on behalf of Knights Templar. He set up temple houses in London and Edinburgh, and when he finally returned to Jerusalem, he had with 300 fully trained and fully equipped knights to join him camping against the Muslims. The Templars reaped the fruits of their activities on Council Troyes, which took place in 1928, which council, the official recognizing the temple by purpose, enabled the organization to rise rapidly during this waning period. In 1130, Bernard Abbot of Clairvaux Abbey published the tracer in praise of the knighthood, which would establish the status of Knights Templar. The Templars created a wild progressive network in Europe, especially in France and England. In short time, the number of knights had exceeded 300. The number of people working in background for organization was much higher. Thanks to efforts of Council of Troyes, Bernard the Knights Templar became the official responsibility as the war ideology in the by passing with the call of Crusher. However, they would gain their real power with the bulls issued after that. Between 1133 and 1151, papacy issued the 26 bulls in support of Templars. Many of them granted or ordered various concessions that could be considered reasonable, but omte datum optimum issued an instapation to in 1139, guaranteed in Templars immense power. With this bull, the Knights Templar were placed under the protection of the papacy, and moreover, an armonious proposing were given the order. Various prevaries, such an exemption of the curses, taxes, the rights collect taxes from the their own committees, to unconditionally confiscate the spoils often aided in wars in with Muslims, exemption from the old church trials in Europe and the East, and not being dependent on any worldly authority, were just a few of them. So that these concessions would allow Knights Templar to act as autonomous papal state in many areas of Catholic Church for the next two centuries. The first step after this stage was institutionalized. The organization had the place in material and spiritual power of in this institutions, bases and further enlarged in the world. In order to do this, many temple houses were built in west and east. In this way, the Templars soon formed a wild network covering all of Europe and the Crusaders kingdoms. Temple houses consisted of multiple buildings built close together and piece of the land. They were often built in important cities, strategic areas and trade routes and functioned multifunctionally. During the mobilization period, the primary purpose of the houses was to provide money, weapons, horses and food to crusaders and to ensure their transfer. In addition, they had important functions in the banking system and the transfer of pilgrimism to the late Holies. They coveted their own lands, imported and exported certain goods, spread the cult ideology, and trained new soldiers to fight Muslims in the name of Catholic Church. In short, the entire organization of the Templars was shaped around the houses. Sect in members in Templar houses coveted their land. They were making money for the order protections. Products such as wool, ceramics, meat, and wine. In addition, they collected taxes from the peasants and farmers living under the control of the organization. However, these revenues were only a small part of general income. The wealth of Templars depended largely on loot from wars, donations made by wealthy European nobles to the order and well-organized banking system. After the Council of Troyes of 1129, the Templars had become an elite troops and professional armies of the Crusaders. Especially of the Second Crusader, they started to take an active role in most expeditions. This brought with massive increase in revenue. Almost all the spoils from the wars with the Muslims went into Templars' coffers. In addition, the profit they made from logistics and herbicle and they undertook during the expedition was also worth mentioning. Another important source of income for the order was donation made by wealthy European nobles. According to historical Cyril Mihail the Nice, who wanted to join Templars, had to donate all their assets to organization. In this way, the Templars had acquired great wealth very soon after their establishment. However, the donations collected were limited to this. Before the Council of Troyes, 21 different donations were received from non-sect European noble kings and the queens. With the Council, the official renegation or organization, the papers resulted to tremendous increase in amount of donations from the outside of the order. So much so that the Templars collected only 21 donations between 1120, 1129, and more than 600 donations were collected between 1129, 1150. Most of the were the movable goods such as gold, silver, weapons, and horses. In addition to do this, they also obtained a considerable amount of the land and real estate donations. They used some of for themselves and rented the other part. In this way, they were generating income from very property under their control. The Order of the Knights Templar was formed to project pilgrimage routes and the Holy Lands. In the first year of the organization establishment, its actives were generally limited to pocket money kingdoms. They transported the pilgrims they took from the port cities such as Akka, Jaffa, and Arsuf. Pilgrimage centers the inner religions, especially Jerusalem. However, as they sank grave, so did the scope of the protection. By the middle of the 12th century, the Templars had a wide range of activities covering many countries in Europe. Pilgrims who set out from various parts of Europe passed the roads protected by Knights of the Templar, stayed in the temple house, sailed with their ships and struggled to pilgrimage center under the protection of the sect. However, this journey was too long, grueling, and dangerous. The pilgrimage routes were filled with the groups they set up, ambitious to the rope for the pilgrim of the valuables and money they were carrying. Aware of such of dangers due to their work, the Templars eventually developed a bank system that would secure the asset of the pilgrim. This system in based of delivering nearest temple branch of their money pilgrim on their way from Europe and valuables, as written in history, on personal information on money on the get document stating that he delivered the money for the Templar of the house. And the journey, such as reaching Jerusalem, pilgrimage in Jerusalem, he handed his documents to member of the temple branch and received payment for amount he had delivered in Europe. Of course, during this process, but both temple houses were deducting and carrying amount of commission for themselves. In the beginning, the system had a simple infractions that consisted to safety delivering the money of the pilgrim of the Hajj centers. However, the Templars developed their commercial activities in this area over time and established a primitive version of today's banking system, also benefiting from Islamic economics. By the end of the 12th century, they were providing many services that encoded in today's banking sector, such as providing loans to countries and individuals, paying pensions, supplying taxes and remittance transactions. In return for the easy transactions, they issued receipt stating for the name, Templar member and client, the date of the transaction and the amount of the transaction. For example, the receipt issued for transaction made in 1295-1296 include the names of member of organization such as Balvius, Johannes, Martinus and Renius. Thanks to their banking activities, the Templars soon became an international financial institution that provided all kinds of cash needs European kings, clergy and nobles. Founded around 1190 by 99s, the order had more than 20,000 members by the middle of the 12th century. Their fleet had reached a size that could compete with primitive republics such as Venice and Genoa. Now the Templars gave loans to famous kings, the nobles of Europe, and if payment was not made on that time, they foreclosed on their assets. In this way, they even had a chance to interfere internal affairs of the countries from time to time. Founded in name the Power Soldiers of Christ, the Knights Templar had become the wealthiest organization in Europe about 20 years after the establishment. This rise led the exercise mysterious treasure deals with Templars as well now legendary narratives such as Holy Grail and Sword of Throne. However, it does not seem possible today to prove most of these exercises historically, and their claims put award the generally at the level conspiracy theory. On the other hand, historical records show that the wealth of the Templars was obtained through the methods such as donation, loot, banking and commercial activities mentioned in this video. From this point of view, the Knights Templar seems to be much more commonplace than in conspiracy theories, but just as powerful as rich. The rise of the Knights Templar was swift and dramatic. Likewise, their decline and unexpected. However, we plan to cover this issue and the military sector of the sect in more detail in another video. Therefore, if you want the continuation of this series, do not forget to specially in the comments. Hope you see you in the next video.